Would people be shocked to find out that that golden calf that caused people to sin when they were in the wilderness was not a golden calf at all, but a real animal that they chopped up, burned, chopped up, and ate? Because that's the true idol that people still have, that very same idol today, and are doing the same abominations as they did in the wilderness. And this is why they have been blinded. This is why they still remain in the wilderness, in darkness. Even though the scribes hid the truth from us, we can still see it peeping through many places. Check this out. This is Exodus 32:20. If you go look at Exodus and the Codex Sinaiticus, oh, they tried to burn it up. They didn't want you having the true law. But and took the calf which they had made, just like if you make a chicken, if or if I say, hey, I made a turkey, I made a ham, that's what they mean by made. There was no gold. And this is why we'll see in Acts, it doesn't talk about this calf being golden. That was a crock of crap that they fed us. No, they ate this calf. Okay, this is what they did. And they took the calf they had made. How did they make it? They burned it in the fire, ground it into powder, scattered it over the face of the water in your little soup, and made drink the sons of Israel. And said Moses to Aaron, what did do you people this that you brought upon them sin great? This is the original sin. In fact, it's spelled differently in Hebrew, and it also looks differently in Greek. If you translate it, it actually, well, I'm not going to get into that right now. Anyway, this is the original sin that causes all the other failures to go along with it, all those strange, lustful desires. This is what they like to call fornication. But really, fornication has to do with eating flesh. But yes, it does cause perversion, sexual desires. But true fornication is just eating of flesh. Murdering animals, eating of flesh, also known as voodoo, is what the true definition of fornication is. They hid that from you. Now, this is Acts 7:41. They throw all these words together. You need to learn how to break them down so you can know the truth. But anyway, they made a calf the same way they make a chicken in the days those and offered, okay, and actually this is like brought up an offering, the idol. What is the idol? The calf is the idol. The same idol that it talks about, Jezebel feeding to the people. It's literally animal flesh, voodoo. You're still eating it today. This is why most of you remain retarded, blind, ignorant, don't know what's going on. I couldn't even translate the scriptures properly until I had completely got off the flesh. Okay, and then where it says rejoicing, no, this is them feasting. This is why God hates your feast days. See this? This is you feasting on that calf. That's your idol. And when you feast on that calf, you're literally, your body is literally a temple for devils. You have now offered yourself up to devils. This is why Messiah said to drink of the word of God so the Holy Spirit can live in you. Because most people have a spirit living in them. It is the Antichrist spirit living in them. It is the spirit of lies. It is those demons, those devils living in you. And the reason that they are able to inhabit your body is because you're participating in voodoo sin. So, anyway, all that gold was a crock of crap. The calf was a real animal that they drank, and that's the original sin. And we can also, when God is saying he has something against the people, it's because they're still participating in this voodoo. And they changed part of it in Revelations, but anyways, but I have something against you. This is against. They like to say according to when they're trying to hide. No, he has something against them. You tolerate, and actually, this isn't really tolerate. You release the woman. They release. This is the same word they say means forgive. Nope. Just means they like, I don't know how to say it. So God sent his son to release us from our sins. In fact, forgiveness, if you go look at it, it literally will translate release sins, but they hide what sin, the word sin in Greek, they hide it from us. They don't translate it. They'll put it on the end, but they don't translate it because then you really know what's going on in the parables and you'll notice what sin is. Sin is what's in their cup, sin is what they're eating. Anyways, very first lesson in the Bible that everyone just, oh, well, we can eat this, but we can't eat this. We can't eat a pig. No, when you eat flesh, you are the pig. You are the swine. You are the Edomite. You are the mouse. When you eat flesh, you will be thrown into the lake of fire because when you sow sin, now you're going to reap it. And most people won't even know what sin is until they're asses on fire. Okay, just like the Holocaust, most of you won't even know what sin is until you're burning on fire and you can feel the pain that you've been causing these animals. In fact, the animals are going to end up hunting your butt down and eating your butt, you keep eating that flesh. God is just. So, anyway, he has something against you. That you release the woman Jezebel, the one calling herself a prophet, and teaching and misleading the servants to what they say commit sexual immorality. No, this is literally eating of flesh, okay? This is the true translation of fornication is eating of flesh. That does cause all the other perversions because that went along with it. All the other failures starts with you eating of flesh because now you take on the spirit of devils and have the same wants and desires as them. This is why we're supposed to take on the spirit, the Holy Spirit. And in order to take on the Holy Spirit, you need to eat of life. And that is the word of God, Isaiah 55. Go read that one and go see who was going, the witness that was going to bring you that word, which nobody seems to recognize because. Hey, you don't recognize the Father, you ain't gonna recognize the Son. It's one and the same. And when it says those that have seen him, those that behold him, which means you understand his word, most people have no idea what his word is saying. In fact, parable itself means hidden covenant. The Messiah came to reveal what the hidden covenant, that's what that means. Anyways, they're eating. These idols, which is flesh, and they cram two words together here, okay? Just like you can go in Acts and see they're eating. What's the idol? Flesh is the idol. This is what you're eating. You're doing voodoo, which is also sin, the original sin that causes all the other failures you have in your life. Okay, but I'm out. I said I was gonna make these short and sweet, and that's what I plan on doing.